Welcome all of you. Today's our discussion topic is nothing but inverters. So what is mean by inverter? Inverter is a device that converts DC power into AC power at desired output voltage and frequency. The inverters are classified into two different types: voltage source inverter and the current source inverter. Okay, voltage source inverters are also known as voltage feed inverter. The DC source has a small and negligible impedance in case of voltage source inverter. It has stiff DC voltage source at its input terminals. And in case of current source inverter, it is fed with adjustable current from DC source of high impedance. Okay, that is from a stiff DC current source. Okay, today we are going to discuss a single phase voltage source inverter. Okay, so let us see the operating principle of single phase bridge inverter. As the name suggests, the bridge inverter consists of four thyristors which forms the bridge. So the circuit diagram for single phase bridge inverter is as follows or as below. It consists of the voltage source Vs and the four thyristors. The four diodes are connected in anti-parallel with these four thyristors. The load is connected in between the terminals A and B. This is your thyristor T1. This is the thyristor T4. This is the thyristor T3. And this one is the thyristor T2. The respective diodes are D1, D4, D3 and D2. The input current or source current is denoted as IS and the output current is denoted as I0. The voltage source is Vs. This is the circuit diagram of the single phase bridge inverter. Now, while considering the working of single phase bridge inverter, we have to note here that the thyristor T1, T4 as well as T3 and T2 are in series with each other and they are connected across the voltage source Vs. Now, during the operation of the single phase bridge inverter, it is should be noted that no any thyristor which is connected in series with each other should get turned on simultaneously. So we have to turn on the thyristor T1 and T2 together and the thyristor T3 and T4 together. But the thyristor T1 and T4 should not get turned on together, as well as thyristor T3 and T2 should not get turned on together. The load may be the resistive load, it may be the RL load or it may be the RLC load. Now the output voltage is independent of all these three loads, but the current is dependent upon the load or nature of the load. You will see the output waveforms, output voltage and output current waveforms, along with the gate current of thyristor T1, T2, T3 and T4. Now here at time period t is equivalent to 0, we are going to turn on the thyristor T1 and T2. So here we are going to turn on the thyristor T1 and T2 by applying the gate pulse at the gate of the thyristor T1 and T2. So the current flowing through the gate of thyristor T1 and T2 is Ig1 and Ig2. Now what will be the output current? Okay, see here, when the thyristor T1 and T2 gets turned on, what will be the output current? Output current will flow from the voltage source Vs through thyristor T1 through the load, okay, through thyristor T2 again to the voltage source. So what is the current direction? From A to B, which is the conventional current direction of the output current. Okay, it is considered as a positive current. Okay, so we will consider the magnitude of output current is equivalent to I naught and it is positive during this period. Okay, now the output voltage, if you look after this circuit diagram, okay, the positive terminal of voltage source, it is connected to the terminal A, while the negative terminal is connected to the terminal B. So what is the output voltage? It is equivalent to Vs during this period. Okay, now at time instant t is equivalent to t by 2, okay, we are going to turn off the thyristor t1 and t2 by forced commutation. At the same time, we are going to turn on the thyristor t3 and t4, okay, by applying the gate pulse at the gate of these two thyristors. Okay, so here the gate current is ig3 as well as IG4 is flowing through the gate of thyristor T3 and T4 to turn on the thyristor T3 and T4. Okay, now during this time period, what will happen? The current flowing through the circuit is from this voltage source through the thyristor T3, through the load, through thyristor T4 to the again voltage source Vs. So what is the current direction? Now current is flowing from terminal B to A, which is exactly opposite to the previous case. Okay, so here the output voltage is negative during this period. Okay, so here the voltage is equivalent to minus Vs. Okay, from the time period or between the time period from t is equivalent to t by 2 to t. Okay, so here the voltage is negative during this time period. Again, at this time instant, okay, we are going to turn off the thyristors T3 and T4 and we are again going to turn on T1 and T2. Okay, so this cycle repeats and again your output voltage and output current, okay, these are, okay, like this. Okay, so see here, the input voltage is positive. Sorry, the input voltage is DC and the output voltage is alternating plus Vs and minus Vs. So, this is nothing but a DC to AC converter. Okay, so this is the basic principle of single phase bridge inverter. Okay, now why we are using the diodes D1, D2, D3 and D4 in this circuit? Okay, when we are using the resistive load, there is no any necessity of using these diodes D1, D2, D3 and D4 because your current is in phase with your output current is in phase with your output voltage. But when we are using the RL load as well as RLC load, the output current is not in phase with the output voltage. Okay, so that to allow the current to flow through, we have to use the diodes D1, D2, D3 and D4 when these thyristors are in off condition. Okay, so here when we are using resistive load, no any necessity of using these diodes, but when we are using RLC and RL load, okay, we have to use the diodes D1, D2, D3 and D4 so that the diodes D1, D2, D3 and D4 are known as the feedback diodes. Okay, the nature of output voltage does not depend upon the type of the load, but the nature of output current depends upon which type of load connected in between the terminals A and B. Okay, so what is the nature of output current? We will see. So here the output voltage does not depend upon the output nature of the load. Okay, so output voltage is equivalent to Vs for the time period in between 0 to t by 2 and it is equivalent to minus Vs for the time period in between t by 2 to t. But what about the output current? Output current is equivalent to I naught Okay, for the time instant, t is equivalent to 0, t, 2t, and so on, and it is equivalent to minus I naught for the time period t is equivalent to t by 2, 3t by 2, 5t by 2, and so on. Okay, this is the equation for the output current. Now suppose we are considering that the output or the load is other than the resistive load, then what will be the case? Okay, consider here the RLC load. Okay, this is RL and C load in between the terminal A and B. Okay, this is your output voltage V naught. The output current is equivalent to I naught. The voltage equation for the circuit model for the time period 0 to t by 2 is given by, okay, by observing the circuit, what is the output voltage? Output voltage is equivalent to Vs for the time period 0 to t by 2. Okay, so the output voltage equation is Vs is equivalent to R into I naught plus L di naught by dt plus 1 by C integration from I naught dt plus Vc1. So what is Vc1 here? Vc1 is nothing but the initial voltage across the capacitor. At t is equivalent to 0. Okay, we consider this as equation number 1. Okay, now for the time period t in between t by 2 to t, or we can say this as 0 to t dash in between 0 to t by 2. Okay, what is the output equation? For this time duration, the output voltage is equivalent to minus V naught, Vs. Okay, so that the output equation is minus Vs is equivalent to R into I naught plus L di naught by dt dash plus 1 by C integral of I naught with respect to dash plus Vc2. This is our equation number 2. Okay, again Vc2 is nothing but the initial voltage across the capacitor at t is equivalent to 0. Okay, differentiating this equation. Okay, differentiating these equations, we are getting d square I naught by dt square r by I L di naught by dt plus 1 by LC I naught is equivalent to 0. In the same manner, d square I naught by dt dash square plus R by L di naught by dt dash plus 1 by LC I naught is equivalent to 0. The solution of these second order differential equation can be obtained by using initial conditions. Components contributing the load decides the nature of the load current waveform. The various current waveforms and different load characteristics we are now going to see here. Okay, if the load is the resistive load, then what will happen here? Okay, we will consider the waveforms. Okay. The output voltage waveform, okay, is shown here. Know that for the different time instant, the output voltage waveform, we have seen it earlier. Okay. The output voltage is plus Vs, here it is minus Vs. Vt/2, 2t and so on. Okay, this is the output voltage Vs and minus Vs. Okay, if you are using the resistive load, the load current waveform I naught is identical with the load voltage waveform, as the output voltage and output current are in phase with each other. Okay, so the output waveform, output current waveform is given as, okay, I naught for this time period from 0 to t/2 and minus I naught for the period, okay, t/2 to t and so on. Okay, this is for resistive load. Okay, so during this time period, the thyristor T1 and T2 are in on condition, and during this time period, thyristor T3 and T4 are in on condition. Okay, and so on. Okay, this is for the resistive load. Now what happens if the RL load is used? Okay, what happens if the RL load is used here? Okay, before time period T is equivalent to 0, here, okay, see here, before time period T is equivalent to 0, okay, thyristor T3 and T4 are conducting. Okay, at time period T is equivalent to 0, T3 and T4 are turned off due to the forced commutation. Okay, the load current is negative, okay, when the thyristor T3 and T4 are conducting. Okay, so here this current is shown by minus I naught at time T is equivalent to 0. Okay, T4 are turned off at time period T is equivalent to 0 here. They are turned off at time period T is equivalent to 0. Okay. But the current I naught cannot change instantly. Okay. It will take some time to change its direction. Okay. So here, as the nature of the load. Okay. So as a result, now the diodes D1 and D2, okay, starts conducting and carry the load current through it. Okay, so that now the current direction is from Vs through diode D2, okay, from terminal B to A through diode D1 and through towards the voltage source. Although the thyristors T1 and T2 are turned on at this instant, okay, due to the voltage drop across diode D1 and D2, the thyristor T1 and T2 will remain in reverse bias mode. Okay, so that now the current flowing through the diodes, okay, goes on reducing. At this time instant, it will become equivalent to 0. Okay, at the moment when the current flowing through diode D1 and D2 becomes equivalent to 0, thyristor T1 and T2 gets turned on. Okay, and now the current starts flowing from Vs through thyristor T1 through the load through thyristor T2, okay, to the Vs. Okay, so here the current direction is positive and it starts increasing. Okay, so during this time period, diode D1 and D2, okay, they are conducting. Okay, when it becomes equivalent to 0, then thyristor T1 and T2 starts conducting. Okay, now at instant T is equivalent to t/2, okay, thyristor T3 and T4 we are going to turn on. Okay, so as the thyristor T3 and T4 gets turned on, okay, the current will not reverse its direction, so that now the current starts flowing through the diodes D3 and D4. Okay, so as the diodes D3 and D4 are conducting, okay, the thyristor T3 and T4, although they are turned on, they will not conduct. Okay, and now the current starts flowing through the diodes D3 and D4. Okay, at this moment it will become equivalent to zero. Okay, as this current becomes equivalent to zero, okay, now, okay, as this current now here becomes equivalent to zero, okay, now the current starts flowing through the thyristor T3 and T4. So what is the current direction? Okay, it is reversed, okay, that is negative. So current reverses its direction and becomes negative. Okay, so this cycle continues. Okay, this is your T3 and T4 and so on. Okay, so during this period, again, diodes D1 and D2 are in on conduction condition, T1 and T2 are in on condition, and so on. So what is this case? This is nothing but the RL load. Okay, now in the same manner, when we are using the RLC load, okay, so what will happen when we are using the RLC load? Okay, the same condition is there, but we have to consider two conditions. Okay, RLC is overdamped and RLC is underdamped. Okay, RLC is overdamped and RLC is underdamped. So what will happen in this case? Okay, in the same manner here, okay, before time period T is equivalent to zero, okay, thyristor T3 and T4 are conducting, okay, and so that here the current flowing through, okay, the output terminals is negative, that is minus I0. As you are using the overdamped RLC circuit or RLC load here, okay, so as soon as, okay, here at this time period we are going to turn off the thyristor T3 and T4, okay, so current will not reverse its direction instantly, okay, so that now the diodes D1 and D2 starts conducting, so that the current, okay, it starts decreasing towards the zero. Okay, it starts decreasing towards the zero. At this instant it becomes zero, okay, and now, okay, the thyristors T1 and T2, okay, which are already turned on, okay, now starts conducting. Okay, here the current is now positive from terminal A to B. Okay, so it starts increasing. At this instant, it becomes equivalent to I0. Okay, now at this instant, thyristor T3 and T4 gets turned on. Okay, but as the current will not reverse its direction instantly, okay, so that here, as the current will not change or reverse its direction instantly, okay, what will happen in this case? Okay, again the diodes D3 and D4 starts conducting as in the previous case, okay, so that the current direction is from Vs through D4, okay, from terminal A to B, again through diode D3 and to the voltage source. So current is positive in this case. Okay, so here becomes positive. Okay, at this instant the current becomes zero. Okay, so that now the thyristors, okay, T3 and T4 gets turned on, and what will be the current direction? It is reverse, that is negative. Again it starts increasing in reverse direction. Here it becomes equivalent to minus I0. So this cycle continues. This is T3 and T4. Okay, so as the cycle continues, your output waveform will be like this. Now what happens when, okay, your output waveform is like this? Okay, so during this time period D3 and D4 are on. During this time period T3 and T4 on. Okay, again during this time period D1 and D2 are on. Okay, during this time period T1 and T2 are in on condition. Okay, so this is RLC overdamped. Okay, now what will happen if RLC is underdamped? okay, in case of RLC under damped condition. Okay, now here, before time period T is equivalent to 0, okay, the diodes D3 and D2 are conducting. Okay, here during this time period, from time T is equivalent to 0 up to time instant T1, here, okay, the thyristors T1 and T2 are in on condition. Okay, as the circuit or the load is underdamped here, okay, what will happen? Before the thyristor T3 and T4 gets turned on, your thyristor T1 and T2 gets turned off. Okay, now from here onwards, the current will flow as these thyristor T1 and T2 are in off condition, and we have not yet turned on the thyristor T3 and T4. Okay, so what will be the current direction now? Current now starts flowing through the diodes D3 and D4. Sorry. The current now starts flowing through the diodes D1 and D2 during this time period, which are connected in anti-parallel with these thyristors. Okay, so current will start flowing through diode D1 and D2. Okay, at this instant, now we are going to turn on the thyristors T3 and T4. Okay, so that the current starts flowing through the thyristors T3 and T4 during this time period. Okay, here the thyristor T3 and T4 are conducting. Okay, at this instant, the current becomes 0, but yet the thyristors T1 and T2 is not turned on. Okay, so what will happen? Now the current starts flowing through the diodes D3 and D4. Okay, so here the current will start flowing through diode D3 and D4. Okay, and the current is like this. Okay, so current direction is from D4 through D3 to like this. Okay, and so on. So under damped condition, output waveform will be like this. Okay, so this is all about your single phase bridge inverter. Okay, we have seen the circuit diagram, the working principle of single phase bridge inverter. Okay, the basic voltage and current waveforms. The three conditions are RLC overdamped and RLC underdamped, and the different waveforms, output current waveforms under these conditions. Okay, now we are going to discuss the voltage control techniques of the single phase inverter. Okay, so AC loads, in many applications, the AC load may require constant or adjustable voltage at their input terminals. So when such loads are fed by inverters, it is essential that the output voltage of the inverter is so controlled as to fulfill the requirements of the AC load. Okay, so we have to study the voltage control techniques, okay, which are used in the inverters. Okay, there are various methods to control the output voltage of the inverter. First one is the external control of AC output voltage. The second one is nothing but the external control of DC input voltage, and the third one is nothing but internal control of inverter. In case of external control of AC output voltage, we are going to control the AC output voltage of inverter. In case of external control of DC input voltage, we are going to consider the DC input voltage of inverter. And in case of the internal control of internal inverter, the voltage is controlled internally. okay, within the inverter itself. Okay, so again we will consider the first case, that is external control of AC output voltage. There are two possible methods to control the AC output voltage externally. The first one is the AC voltage control, and the second one is series inverter control. In case of AC voltage control, okay, here the AC voltage controller is inserted in between the output terminals of the inverter and the load terminal. Okay, so here is our inverter. It is fed with the constant DC voltage. Okay, the output of this inverter is now fed to the AC voltage controller. Okay, it will provide the controlled AC voltage, okay, which is now applied to the AC load. The voltage input to the AC load is now controlled through the firing angle control of AC voltage controller. This method gives rise to higher harmonic content in the output voltage. Okay, higher harmonic content in the output voltage, particularly when the output from AC voltage controller at the low levels. Okay, so this method is rarely employed except the low power applications. Okay, the second method is nothing but the series inverter control. Okay, in case of series inverter control, okay, here we are using two or more inverters in series with each other. Okay, so here we are considering two inverters are connected in series with each other. This is the inverter 1. This is our inverter 2. Okay, it is fed with the constant DC voltage. The output of this inverters, they are connected in series with each other with the help of the transformer. The output voltage of these two transformers, the secondary of these two transformers is connected in series with each other. The output voltage of first transformer is denoted as VO1 and the output voltage of second transformer is denoted as VO2. This is the total output voltage. Okay. The output voltage is nothing but the phases of two fundamental voltages VO1 and VO2. So the output voltage equation is given as Vout is equivalent to VO1 square plus VO2 square plus 2 times VO1 into VO2 to cos theta raised to 1/2. It is essential that the frequency of the output voltages VO1 and VO2 from the two inverters is same. Okay, now when the theta is equivalent to 0, at that time output voltage is equivalent to VO1 plus VO2. Okay, and for theta is equivalent to pi, okay, V out is equivalent to 0. Okay, in case of VO1 is equivalent to VO2. The angle theta can be varied by the firing angle control of the thyristors or the two thyristors used in the two inverters. Okay, the series connection of inverters is called as the multiple control converter control. Okay, it does not introduce the harmonic content even at the low output voltage levels. Okay, which is in the case of previous method. Okay, so these are the two different methods of voltage external control of AC output voltage. Okay, now the next method of voltage control is external control of DC input voltage. Okay. In case the available voltage source is AC, then the DC voltage input to the inverter is controlled through. Okay, that means if input is a constant AC voltage instead of DC voltage, what we have to do? We have to use a full controlled rectifier which is fed, the output of which is fed to the filter. Okay, the output of filter is nothing but the controlled DC, okay, which is now fed to the inverter. Okay, so that we will obtain the controlled DC, sorry, controlled AC voltage. At the output. Okay, so this is the first method. Okay, when our input voltage is constant AC voltage, we have to first convert it into a controlled DC voltage. Okay, so that we will obtain the controlled AC voltage at the output. Okay, now we can use the uncontrolled rectifier also, okay, to convert the constant AC voltage into a controlled AC voltage. Okay, so in this case we are using the uncontrolled rectifier . Okay, the output of which is fed to the chopper . Okay, so chopper is DC to DC converter . Okay, the output here, input here is constant AC voltage. The uncontrolled rectifier will provide you the DC voltage, which is again fed to the chopper. Chopper will provide you the DC voltage, DC to DC voltage. Okay, now here the filter is used to filter out the unwanted components. The output of filter is now the controlled DC voltage, which is fed again to the inverter. Okay, and output of inverter is now again the controlled AC voltage. Okay, so we can convert the constant AC voltage into controlled AC voltage with the help of uncontrolled rectifier, chopper, filter and the inverter. Okay, now here again one more method is there to convert the constant AC voltage into controlled AC voltage. Okay, so for that what we have to use? We have to use the AC voltage controller . Okay, here the input is constant AC voltage. The output of this is connected to the controlled uncontrolled rectifier. Output of uncontrolled rectifier is provided to the filter, okay, which will provide you the controlled DC voltage, okay, which is fed to the inverter, okay, which will provide you the controlled AC voltage. Now in this case, we are using or we are converting constant AC voltage into controlled AC voltage. Okay, if the available voltage is DC, then the DC voltage input to the inverter is controlled by means of a chopper. Okay, so here we are using the chopper to convert constant DC voltage into the AC controlled AC voltage. So here we are using chopper to convert the constant DC voltage into desired DC level. Okay, here we are using the filter okay, which will provide you the controlled DC voltage, which is provided as input to inverter. Okay, which will again provide you the controlled AC voltage. Okay, so these are the four different methods to convert the external voltage control of DC input voltage. Okay, now okay, the main advantage of this method is nothing but the output voltage waveform and its harmonic content are not affected, as the inverter output voltage is controlled through the adjustment of DC input voltage only. Okay, so here the output voltage waveform will not affect, but there are certain disadvantages of this methods. What are these advantages? The number of power converters used for the control of inverter output voltage varies from 2 to 3. Okay, so that as more power handling stages are there, okay, it will result in more losses and reduced efficiency of the entire scheme. Okay, now here again, for reducing the ripple content of DC output voltage to the inverter, the filter circuits are required in all types of schemes. Okay, and as the filter circuit increases, the cost, weight and size of the system also increases. Okay, so here these are the different disadvantages of this. Okay, the last method is nothing but the internal control of inverter. To control the voltage. Okay, the output voltage from an inverter is adjustable by exercising or control within the inverter itself in this method. Okay, the most efficient method of doing this is phase width modulation control. Okay, we are using the pulse width modulation technique to control the output voltage. In this method, a fixed DC input voltage is given to the inverter and a controlled AC output voltage is obtained by adjusting the turn on and turn off period of the inverter components. Okay, what are the advantages of using this PWM technique? Okay, so it is, first one is nothing but the output voltage control with this method can be obtained without any additional equipment. Okay, so no any additional equipment is required to control the output voltage. Okay, so with this method, the lower order harmonics can be eliminated. Okay, so all the lower order harmonics can be eliminated using this method, PWM technique. Okay. And higher order harmonics can be filtered out easily by using the filtering techniques. Okay, so that the internal control of inverter is the easiest way and most widely used method to control the output voltage. Okay, so PWM inverters are quite popular in the industrial applications to control the output voltage. Okay, so in this lecture we have seen the working principle of the single phase bridge inverter. Okay, the load conditions, that is the for resistive load, RL load and RLC load, what will be your output current waveform and output voltage waveform. Then we have seen the voltage control techniques, okay, that is the external control control of AC output voltage, the external control of AC DC input voltage and the internal control of inverter. Okay, so all these techniques we have seen here. Okay, so thank you very much.